Multiple victims are confirmed dead in a mass shooting in Canada. Authorities say at least five were killed in Vaughan City in Ontario after a gunman opened fire at a residential area Sunday. Another victim is in critical condition. Police say the suspect has died in an exchange of gunfire with authorities. They have yet to identify the shooter's motive. Vaughan's Mayor Stephen Del Duca offers his condolences to the victims.
Nearly half of all health workers in the Philippines have yet to receive their second COVID booster shot. That's according to the health department. It says more than 600,000 out of the country's 1.2 million medical personnel have yet to get the fourth shot. The agency began giving out the shots to high-risk groups in May. It has yet to greenlight the rollout for the general public. Finance Secretary Ben Diokno says there is absolutely no link between the executive order reducing the Development Bank of the Philippines' dividend to the national government to 0% and the proposed DBP investment in the proposed Maharlika Investment Fund. Diokno made this assertion after House Deputy Minority Leader Franz Castro said the EO may favor the proposed Maharlika Fund rather than the national budget. Marcos earlier ordered the reduction to support the capital position of the DBP and sustain its role in the economic recovery of industries adversely affected by the pandemic. Diokno says the reduction in the remittance of dividend has been made long before the Maharlika Fund was conceived in order to improve the ability of government banks to deliver on their mandates and, at the same time, maintain their financial standing. He adds the grant of dividend relief aims to provide DBP with a stronger capital base in support of its mandated developmental programs.
A possible wage hike next year still up in the air. Labor Secretary Bienvenido Laguesma says he does not want to preempt the decision of the regional tripartite wages and productivity boards. Laguesma also chairs the National Wages and Productivity Commission, which hears the appeals to board's decision. But he assures workers the government is already studying the wage hike proposals.
At this point, parang ayaw namin na maging premature ang statement namin dyan. Subalit, alam namin na yung mga iba-ibang regional tripartite wages and productivity board ay nagsasagawa na ng kanilang pag-aaral. In fact, yung ating National Capital Region, nagkaroon na sila ng initial na pagdinig nung nakaraang linggo at tuloy-tuloy ang pag-ugong ng paggulong ng proseso.
The Philippine government releases more inmates from the National Penitentiary. Some 118 persons deprived of liberty walked free from the new Bilibid prisons Monday. The Corrections Bureau says they are among the more than 300 inmates freed in several jail facilities across the country. The agency adds close to 6,000 PDLs have been freed this year. It vows to expedite the process for the release of qualified inmates in 2023.
Problema kasi dito sa mga to, kaya hindi lumaya, hindi makalaya. Kulang sa dokumento. Eh, kailangan magpiprepare niyan, abogado rin, di ba? Kaya next year, kung matatayo natin yung paralegal volunteers, bawat region,